feud ends in blood.
I'll take one.
Here you go, sir.
I say we stop this goodwill towards strangers nonsense and focus on what London really needs. Solid leadership, whose hard work will raise everyone up to success. As go the titans of business, so goes the world.
Oi, oi!
You weak fool. Get a job!
The best guards money can buy won't do Mr. Dredge any good.
You!
Jacob, it's me, Sergeant Frederick Appeline.
Freddy.
Sergeant, undercover. There's to be a robbery at the Bank of England, I'm sure of it.
Robbery? It's a fortress.
The boys at the station thought I was joking. Wouldn't be so funny if it was their life savings.
Who's behind it?
That's confidential.
Oh, come on, Freddy. I can help you. Imagine the headlines. Thieves caught in the act. Appeline right all along.
Well, I suppose I can fill you in a little. Every fiscal quarter, a branch of the bank is robbed. Never the same branch. The thieves are supplied by Cockham merchants.
Thanks for the info, Freddy.
It's Sergeant! And I'm keeping my eye on you. If only I knew which shipment it was, then I could trace the weapons to their owner.
Capital idea, Freddy.
Everything you need to survive the strike.
Here we are, the shipping docks. Now, where are the Cockham crates intended for Mr. Plutus?
Thank you.
tea. Maybe later. Where the devil is it? Hello. And now to wait for the crates to be retrieved.
Don't want them tea leaves turned to dust, do we?
Take these crates. Any mistake will cost you dearly.
Keep your knickers on. We hear ya.
Good, because I ain't repeating myself.
It's a shame I can't stop in for a pint. They're nervous. I should keep my distance. Dear sister thinks I'm destroying things. I'll show her how I settle accounts. Templars.
Pleasure doing business with Conqueror.
Boy, where's our money?
Delivery will be tomorrow.
Templars. I yes. Lead me to Mr. Plutus. Doing fine, girl. Atta girl.
Same routine as before. The twopenny opens a vault, we robs it and leaves the money in his storehouse. Look sharp, the boys are waiting.
To the Bank of England. Yeah.
Plutus is twopenny.
What say you?
You're not gonna like it.
Now, see here. I am graced with the Abilene family's robust constitution.
Twopenny's robbing the Bank of England.
The governor of the bank. I think I might need to sit down.
There's no time for that. Bastard's probably deep in the vault by now.
However you get in, I don't want to know.
Of course. But do you know how I can get in?
The bank is designed to protect England's gold reserves. A fortress, guarded under lock and key. There is the bank manager, Mr. Osborne. Only he is allowed free access to the vault. You can spot him near the entrance. And, oh yes, one man keeps a close watch on the vault door. He watches it like a hawk. If he sees you, he's sure to seal it. The guard captain, Gus Howard, knows Twopenny well. He is in on this, I'm certain. Mr. Fry, please use discretion. The only way to implicate Twopenny is to catch him in the act. Do not jeopardize him. No big displays. This is the Bank of England. If you encounter any trouble, I'll be in the atrium. In disguise.
Twopenny won't be leaving that vault. Oh, fancy. Fitting for two pennies, too. Where is Tupini?
Please! I have a family. He's in the vault ogling his priceless paintings.
Has everyone assembled? Yes? Yes? Excellent. I shall begin the tour. We start in the pay hall, the bank's center of activity. This way, please. The Bank of England was founded in 1694 and has been situated.
Hurry now. You will get your cart as promised. Damn your clumsiness!
Sorry, sir.
Hurry now. You will get your cart as promised. You've got the rest of your life to count it, as long as you live.
You've stolen your last shilling from the people of London.
Those animals squander their savings. We are the experts in investment. Nothing would be built or improved. Nothing would rise above the muck without our hand guiding. No creating the future. They benefit as much as their work.
It is their city, not yours.
Without our investments, there would be no city.
For the path of the dead.
The people of England. The Bank of England is closed until further notice.
Currency, a laughingstock. Inflation out of control, twopenny brutally murdered.
And yet Parliament does nothing.
The bill will be defeated, sir. That buffoon Disraeli shall be taken care of. It has been arranged, upon my honor.
Your honor carries little weight.
How dare you, sir!
The poor people of this city have suffered enough. Today I granted a significant rise to my staff in order to counter inflation.
What?
I would supply all of London if I could. Meanwhile, you sit in your club and wax poetic with promises your honor cannot pay. Your family's fortune, however. I wonder what they would offer to keep your record out of the newspapers. About the same as Disraeli would offer for your balls, I'd wager. But let's be generous. Why limit ourselves to one or the other, when we can have it all? What say you, sir? Shall I come collect? No more dallying. The halls of Parliament must be free to govern. Again! Understood? You may see yourself out.
Dear Mr. Starrick, men hired. Strike tomorrow. Disraeli's death will stall Corrupt Practices Act indefinitely. Gladstone will be far more pliable. May the father, etc., etc., be. So Starrick's got his finger in politics, has he? I need to enter the Sinopian Club and find out who B is.
Tread delicately around Parliament.
As if I don't usually.
Your indiscretion at the Bank of England caused British currency to nearly collapse.
Nearly is the operative word. Speaking of collapses, what of the key you found that unlocks very little?
Henry took it for research. I am confident that the vault is ours.
Nearly ours, Evie. Nearly.
Run, brother of mine.
Mignonette, your qualities surpass your charms.
I'm not entirely sure that's meant as a compliment. Love in a Mist. That's a pretty name.
Alternatively called Devil in a Bush.
Narcissus. Self-love. I should buy a bouquet for Jacob.
Most unkind, Miss Fry.
As amusing as all this is, I really should be getting back to work. If you need me...
I'll send a bouquet.
Of irises?
A message. Indeed.
A gherkinite. Just like father's.
All right, B. Who are you, and what's your game? If it isn't my dear old chum, Mr. Disraeli. Now, Prime Minister, which of your friends is about to stab you in the back?
A vital step in reforming our government. If the majority party is allowed to dictate the results of contested elections, we can scarcely call ourselves free.
If we yield up our rights bit by bit to the courts, we can scarcely call ourselves free, sir.
This is so like you, Gladstone. You would rather throw your body upon the gears of progress than surrender one iota of power.
By God, Disraeli, you are a fool! I'll not stand idly by and watch you drag parliamentary privilege through the muck.
No, certainly not. You'd rather return us to the yoke of tyranny? Perhaps while we're at it, Mr. Gladstone, we could repeal Magna Carta and return the crown to the bloody Stuarts!
How dare you, sir? Merely because I do not wish to see government placed in the hands of judges, you would make these slanderous accusations? I'll not stand for it!
Then I shall obviate the requirement. Good evening, sir.
I presume.
Come quickly! It's a murder!
going on now?
Pleasure to meet you. B.
B! My name's Herbert!
Then why are you following the Prime Minister?
It's just the job, sir! Some old bloke paid me to...
Smug bastard. Well, I was born in Crawley, but that's by the by. Who are you working for?
Oh, I never got his name. Old chap, big moustache, wore some kind of uniform. Who's ours, maybe?
What's his game?
Please, you'll kill me.
And a three-story drop will shatter your legs and send you to the workhouse. Difference is you can run from him.
Tomorrow! Oh, my lads are going to attack the Prime Minister's carriage on the way to Parliament.
Perfect.
Anyone, and I promise I'm not going to, so help me God, I won't. Oh! I'll just go, all right? I'm not any...
Oh.
So much for the house call. I have to find a way into that carriage.
Meaning of this? Who the devil are you?
Prime Minister, I'm your new bodyguard, Jacob Fry.
I wasn't informed of any new bodyguard. Who's your commanding officer?
Let the boy speak, Dizzy.
Madam, apologies. But we've learned of a threat on your life. And the Met thought it best to move quickly.
Threat? What sort of threat?
That sort. If you excuse me a moment.
Yeah.
What's all this?
Not so fast, Your Excellency.
Hey! Get back here with that Prime Minister!
About Gladstone, young man.
I assure you, madam, Gladstone is innocent in this.
But he tried to kill my husband.
Well, we'll look into Gladstone. Perhaps you can help me with another inquiry, madam. A gentleman with ties to Parliament, older, wears cavalry uniforms and has a large mustache.
You seem like a rough and ready sort of fellow, Mr. Fry.
Well, yes, I am, actually.
And are you familiar with the poorer districts of our city?
Roughly.
Wonderful. As it happens, I've been eager to tour the Devil's Acre. If you were to escort me, I'd be happy to assist you in your inquiry.
That strikes me as a dangerous idea.
Then it's settled. Come back here to Downing Street tomorrow night, 8 o'clock sharp. Good day, Mr. Fry.
But I...
Good day, Mr. Fry!
Madam?
Mr. Fry.
Ready to take the air? Devil's Acre should just be coming alive.
I'm afraid I must cancel our engagement. The lawn is crawling with scandal-hunting journalists, and I simply cannot be seen in the company of someone so...
I'll see them off. You follow along when it's clear.
Yes, yes. Be gentle, won't you? The press are notoriously touchy about any violence to their person.
Ha ha ha. I'll barely ruffle a hair on their heads.
Shh, Desmond.
That's yours, if you can get those chaps over there to follow me.
Right you are, sir.
What? Help! Someone!
Blimey! Murder! Look! It's Squire Bancroft!
Best lead them astray before they tear me to shreds.
Young man. Dizzy ought to keep you on to deal with the liberals. Now, a drive is in order.
Who's a good horse? You are.
In the cart, it's the Prime Minister's wife, steady on.
I really must not be seen here, Mr. Fry.
That's the way.
Yeah! Yeah!
Doing fine.
Let us avoid these vultures!
That's a girl? On, girl.
Whoa, now!
Keep moving.
Oh, what a rough place. Give me your arm, Mr. Fry. Let us see what the Devil's Acre has to offer.
Is your dog quite all right?
Oh, Desmond's fine. He's just not overfond of strangers. Or cats. No, this gentleman is a... Oh, what was it? Yes, a costermonger, of all things. Remarkable how the working classes occupy themselves, isn't it?
Very industrious, I'm sure. Shall we go?
Please! I don't want to die in a bitch!
They seem to be,
the street. I've been married twice, Mr. Fry. I'm fully aware of what they're doing. God bless them.
Do you mind? I don't have the time to get cleaned. No, it's fine. I'm sure I'll do well at tea.
I'll do anything.
I've got an old mother needs to take me out.
What sort of meat is that man selling?
Best not to ask.
Why? Is it something dreadful? Is it rat?
I don't mean to be indelicate, given the present company, but another name for it is Bow Wow Mutton. Here we are, the old one-ton pub.
So this is a pint, is it? Remarkable.
Nice doggy.
He's a good doggy.
Good boy, Desmond. Hand over the mutt.
You'll change your tune when me and my friends find you.
Now then, Desmond, to get you back to your mistress, whom I've just left entirely unattended in one of London's most dangerous pubs.
Well, if you never told your father how you felt about him, how was he supposed to know?
I never thought of it that way. I suppose deep down we all just want to be loved.
Just so. Here, have a sweetie. Oh, Desmond and Mr. Fry, I'd like you to meet... Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
John the Tosser.
Charmed. I think we better get you home.
Right you are, Mr. Fry. Come along, Desmond.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the dog walker!
Now, let's not do something we'll regret. Let's go.
Well, I must thank you for a most energetic and enlightening evening, Mr. Fry.
No, thank you.
Perhaps now you might tell me about the man in the Hussar's uniform.
Quite right. Lord Cardigan is the gentleman you seek. Tiresome. Always blathering on about his military adventures.
Do you know where I might find him for a private conversation?
I do indeed. He's in town now, as it happens, campaigning against the corrupt practices bill. Perhaps you could catch him in the Palace of Westminster. Oh, do be careful. The government could ill afford another scandal.
I assure you, I'll be very discreet. Easy does it.
Your stop, madam.
My stop? How delightful. Thank you. Thank you for a splendid evening, Mr. Fry. I shall be sure to speak highly of you to Dizzy. Oh, yes.
Maybe two.
Please tell me again where we are going.
I found a letter from the Prince Consort among Lucy Thorne's research, marked with the same insignia as your key. Dated 1847.
1847.
The same year the prince began renovations to Buckingham Palace.
You think he added a vault for the shroud?
And since there is no map of the palace with the room marked Secret Vault.
Your Highness, may I present Miss Evie Fry. Miss Fry, Maharaja Duleep Singh.
A pleasure, Your Highness.
My friend, the plans you asked for have been removed.
Removed? By whom?
Crawford Starrick, or someone employed by him. Yes, I thought you might recognize the name. I know where they are, but it is heavily guarded.
That part will not be a problem.
I thought not.
We're going to need a plan.
I can provide a distraction for the guards while you find a safe way inside.
Oh, really?
For you, Evie?
Certainly.
Well, once I'm inside, I'll find someone who knows where the papers are stored.
And we will meet back on the train.
Be careful. What's the plan?
When you give the signal, I'll draw the guards into a fight and then use a smoke bomb to get away.
And I'll take advantage of the confusion. Ready?
Absolutely. An assassin!
You're clearly asking to lose some teeth!
That's not them. Nothing here. Looks like I have to ask someone where the plans are.
I swear, miss, I don't know where they've taken him.
Taken who?
The man, dressed like you. The guards dragged him off.
Henry, the plans you stole, where are they?
I don't know anything about that.
The plans. The mission.
You're some of Clara's children.
They took Mr. Henry. We couldn't stop them.
I bit one of them good, though.
They dragged him off in a red carriage.
They won't get far, though. One wheel looked like it was about ready to fall off. You can see the cart tracks. It looks so wobbly-like.
Road. They must be driving quickly. They're knocking people over, too.
Come on!
And destruction of public property. I must be on the right track.
Around here today. All kinds of unsavory types wandering around, armed to the teeth. I don't like it one bit.
I saw them dragging someone out of the carriage after the wheel fell off. They said he'd hit his head. Not sure why they needed to take him to the church, but that's where they went.
What's she doing here?
She's an intruder!
I could have sworn I'd locked this gate. This is supposed to be locked. Bloody urchins opened it again, no doubt.
Shut up.
assassin. How much more adult can he get? Why did you bring him?
They sent someone to move the architectural plans. Do you have them?
Did they hurt you?
I'm fine.
Let's go.
What about the plans?
The plans are lost.
Evie, I'm sorry.
Just concentrate on escaping, please. Miss Nightingale to look at that. I must find the vault before Starrick secures the shroud.
We'll talk to the Maharaja again.
I will talk to the Maharaja. You will get your head looked at.
I'm sorry my capture hasn't done your plans.
You'd be safer on the train.
Even if you find the vault, you can't just walk into Buckingham Palace alone.
I won't be alone. I'll see you back at the train, Mr. Green.
Robbery! That's what it is!
Ladies and gentlemen, please! If you would just calm yourselves!
What has happened?
Your brother!
What's he done this time?
The newspapers are all over Tupini's murder, and if that weren't enough, someone has stolen the currency printing plates. Was that also Jacob's doing?
I doubt it.
Now, no one trusts the bank or England's currency. There will be inflation, riots, manufacturing will jump to America for the cheap labor. In short, Britain is done for.
Jacob, you've really put your foot in it now. What if I smuggle the plates back into the bank?
Well, it'd certainly help. Better yet, it would call into question the stories on Tupini's murder, which would restore confidence in the economy.
That's settled then. Britain lives to see another day.
Oh, and if it's not too much trouble, would you mind destroying any counterfeit notes you come across so they don't circulate?
Of course.
It really is very good of you to help.
Exportation!
Follow me. The counterfeit money is being spent nearby.
Well, if you can call it counterfeit. With those printing plates, it's nearly impossible to tell the real notes from the fake ones.
Mr. Avalon.
If this gets out... Well, I've said this already. When people don't trust their currency, and we're already seeing riots...
Mr. Aberline.
You better keep your distance.
I have the utmost faith in you, Miss Fry.
You two, follow me. I don't wish to be robbed on my way to the cart.
The counterfeiters.
Heard about the rioting at the bank?
They can riot all they like. We will be giving back those plates.
What difference does it make? It's not like he has any real cash on him.
Since we've got the printing plates, it's all real cash.
Did you hear those crowds? Sounds like all of London is rioting.
Nothing to do with us.
I can't believe Jacob's managed to shatter the entire economy. Father was right. He acts in haste, and repents not at all.
And you know nothing else about it. I'll see you're given double your salary for your trouble.
Paid in your counterfeit bills, no doubt.
I didn't quite catch that.
Nothing at all, sir.
Girl. Come on. Whoa there.
Let this be a lesson to you. Take my pride in your work.
Keep your eyes open. Anyone could be trying to get in.
Yes, sir.
Keep this place locked down.
Yes, sir.
Guard this place as you would the Bank of England itself.
Absolutely, sir.
Now to sneak these back into the bank.
Here now.
else.
There, as if they were never taken.
London papers are running the story of how it was all a hoax. No more riots. Faith in the bank restored. Finally, I might get a quiet night on patrol. Miss Fry, I can't thank you enough.
Glad we've averted catastrophe, Sergeant. Although it's Jacob who should be thanking me.
What's this nonsense about needing a password to see Lord Cardigan today?
Relax. I've got it in my pocket.
Look sharp, men. Allow no one past unless I authorize them.
Cardigan has gone too far this time. I've a mind to contact Scotland Yard myself.
Come now, gentlemen. I thought us united in opposition against this perfidious law.
Pardon me, gentlemen. Sergeant Freddie Abeline of Scotland Yard. Where might this scandalous activity be taking place?
Oh, yes, yes. It's, just this way. Follow me, Sergeant. But discreetly, if you would. One doesn't like to be seen airing a fellow member of Parliament's dirty linen.
What? I'll be very discreet. Usually I would be in disguise, but my clothes all fell into the Thames.
Let me live!
trouble now.
Watch for the rook bombs!
Oh, shit!
Are things really fine?
She could be Prime Minister.
Stay here. I'll fetch the authorities.
Balaclava. Of course it bloody is.
Password.
Balaclava.
Come in.
Now then, let's discuss this like... Good God! Who the bloody hell...
Oh, shut up.
Ah! coward! Villain! Alas, that the hero of Balaclava should fall not on the gloried fields of Crimea, but to an assassin's blade in the very halls of power.
Are you finished yet?
Take your bow, knave, for you have managed what no Russian battery, what no Indian tiger could achieve. Claim your trophy, and may you choke on it.
Yes, but do tell me more about Balaclava.
Farewell. Farewell, dear Britannia. Your dawn shall be dimmer that the Earl of Cardigan sees it not. God save the Queen and the 11th Hussars.
What a prick.
Apart from the death squad on our tail, apart from that.
Backup's on the way. Why are you pushing yourself so hard? It's not your job to fight Templars.
I had this colleague. He was our boss's son. I didn't much care for him at the start. Everyone treated him like he was so bloody special. To me, he just wasn't invested in anything that didn't affect him personally. But I was wrong about him. He became my friend. Put himself through hell, and he saved us all in the end. So I reckon, well, I can't apologize to him, but I can try and live up to his example.
You are a good assassin.
Holy jeez!
Hello. It has been too long.
Galena! Blimey, I have not seen you since we blew up that lab in Paris.
There were many explosions, and you screamed like a baby. Bishop tells me Otzelberg is here. I will kill him for you.
Super. Great news. Now, if you wouldn't mind keeping watch, I am going to lie down and die now.
Rest. We have a big fight coming.
Sean and Rebecca are safe for now, but we're still relying on you to find us that shroud.
Order has bred disorder. The sea rises to flood the pubs and extinguish the street lamps. Our city will die. Tupine has failed. Lucy has failed. Brudenell, Elliotson. Pearl. All have gone into the night. It is up to me now. The assassins have brought nature's fury into our homes. Men have become monsters, barreling toward us, teeth out. Our civilization must survive this onslaught. Prevent a return of the Dark Ages. will start anew. London must be reborn.
The Peace of Eden is under Buckingham Palace. We've got all we need. Let's start planning our infiltration.
Hold on. Better to get visual verification. If we're gonna move, we need to be 100% sure. We'll only get one shot before Otso Berg crashes down on us.
Gotta agree with Sean.
We'll position ourselves near the palace, but we'll wait for you to sync the genetic data before we move.
It's all up to you, Initiate.
You're late. Starik is making his move. The Peace of Eden is somewhere inside Buckingham Palace.
Let him have it.
I've seen your handiwork across the city. Perhaps you should trust my judgment.
I've been killing Starik's henchmen. What have you been doing? Let's ask Henry, shall we?
I have been repairing your mistakes. Too much haste is too little speed.
Don't you quote Father at me.
That's Plato. And I am sorry, this doesn't involve anything you can destroy. Father was right, he never approved of your methods!
Father is dead!
Enough! I have just received word from my spies. At the palace ball tonight, Starik plans to steal the Peace of Eden, and then eliminate all the heads of church and state.
Once more for old time's sake?
And then we're finished.
Agreed. So what's the plan?
Such an unexpected delight to visit you both. What is the news on the street?
Mrs. Disraeli, we have discovered that there is something inside Buckingham Palace that could threaten the...
What my sister's failing to say is that we require entrance into the ball tonight.
Impossible! Even if there were any invitation cards remaining, which there are not, someone of your lowly station...
If that damn fool Gladstone is attending this evening, they can have my card. Perfect. Then I'll go alone.
Mrs. Disraeli, if you would be kind enough to inform my darling brother of the location of the Gladstone's residence, perhaps he could use his considerable skills to commandeer their cards.
What fun! Did you hear that, Dizzy? We're going to pinch the Gladstone's invitations!
Thank you for volunteering me, sweet sister.
Oh, a pleasure, brother, dearest. Now, Mrs. Disraeli, if you would excuse me, I must visit with the Maharaja. It occurs to me that he may have a second set of plans to a certain vault.